Hi, my name is Freddy Molefe. My friends call me BCF. I have been in the health and safety industry since 1973, and I must say I'm very excited to share my knowledge with you in this video. Now that you understand the process around the plan, do, check and act cycle, I would like to spend some time on the planning process. Proper planning involves assessing the level of health and safety that you are currently in and looking at what you want to achieve. In short, what is your goal? When you have a clear understanding of what your goal is, jot down the specifics that you want to achieve and allocate specific responsibilities to specific individuals. Once you've done this, draft how you're planning to achieve your health and safety goals. Also, plan immediately how you're going to rate the effectiveness of your plan and how you will measure your success. Then, decide how you will measure performance. It is extremely important to brainstorm various ways of how performance can be effectively measured, which goes beyond merely looking at your incident figures. You can look for leading indicators as well as lagging indicators. These are also called active and reactive indicators. Just as it is important when you do your planning, consider the essential aspect of emergencies such as fire, injuries, explosions, and any other emergencies. If you share your workshop with other organizations or companies, it is wise to work cooperatively with them to coordinate any plans as they may have an effect on your health and safety. When planning, consider changes that may occur in your workplace well in advance. And remember, there may be changes in legislation and practice as well. You must be able to identify any specific legal requirements that apply to you at all times. That is, in short, your planning phase. In your next video, Nesh Mata Badur has the honor of explaining the DO approach to health and safety. Remember, the health and safety of your employees, contractors, and visitors must always be your number one priority.